Welcome to this tutorial, installing and setting up Python on a Windows 11 system in 10 minutes. The tutorial has four main parts: what to expect, outline, what is the target audience, the main part, let's get started, and finally, some optional information about the making of this tutorial. Let's start with the outline. In this tutorial, we will download Python for Windows from the official website. By using the official website, there is no risk of installing an outdated or bloated version of Python. We will install Python using recommended and useful settings. This will make sure that you do not have hard to solve problems in the future, for example, a need for modifying the Windows registry. We will also install additional tools and libraries for Python. By doing this, you will get familiar with how to install other Python libraries in the future. Finally, we will learn how to use the important so-called Jupyter Notebook environment. Jupyter Notebook is one of the most important Python-related tools. Now, let's see if this is the right tutorial for you. Generally speaking, this tutorial is for students that need Python and Jupyter Notebook for their studies. You could be a student at a traditional university or an online university. Or you could be a student at one of the many so-called massive open online courses. Examples include Udacity, Udemy, and Coursera. This tutorial is also suitable for self-learning individuals who use a book. Now, let's get started with the actual tutorial. Open your browser and go to python.org. Go to the Downloads section for Windows systems. At the top of the page, you find a link to the latest Python release. Now scroll to the bottom of the page and download the recommended Windows installer, 64-bit. Go to your download folder. Please make sure that your Windows system shows file name extensions. This will make your life easier. Go to View, Show, and then select File Name Extensions. Double-click on the downloaded file and select Add Python to Path at the very bottom of the Install Python interface. This will allow you to comfortably call Python commands everywhere in the system. After that, click on Install Now, and let the installation process finish. Make sure that you click on Disable Path Length Limit. This will prevent problems when you later download Python projects from the internet because they typically have complex folder structures. Now start the Windows command prompt by typing cmd in the search field. Then click on Command Prompt. Type Python in the command prompt and check if you get the response that you see here. In case you get an error message, it is possible that you have to restart your computer. You see three larger than symbols at the start of each line. This shows you that you have now started the Python interpreter in the so-called interactive mode. Please type 1 plus 1 and then press Enter. You see that Python returns the result in the next line. To leave the interactive mode of Python, please type Exit, opening bracket, closing bracket, and then press Enter. Let's install a package called IPython that makes the interactive mode a bit more colorful. Type pip install IPython, and press Enter. The installation may take some seconds. Pip is a package management tool that is used to install and manage software packages. Please type IPython, which stands for Interactive Python, and press Enter. This will start IPython. IPython is a powerful command line interpreter. Now we can again calculate the sum of 1 plus 1. You can see that it is more colorful now. In addition, input and output are clearly labeled. To leave IPython, please type exit, opening bracket, closing bracket, and then press Enter. Now we install a famous feature called Jupyter Notebook. Jupyter Notebook is often used in education, when Python is taught to students. Please type pip install Jupyter, and then press Enter. Let's install some more very popular Python features. It is very likely that you will need them anyway. We will install the following Python libraries: NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, and Seaborn. Matplotlib and Seaborn are widely used for data visualization. Seaborn is a more user-friendly library that is actually based on Matplotlib. NumPy and Pandas are essential in data science and related fields. Please type one by one the following commands, each followed by enter. Pip install NumPy. Pip install Pandas. Pip install Matplotlib. Pip install Seaborn. Congratulations, you have reached an important milestone in this tutorial. Please close the Windows command prompt. We will now create a project folder for our first Python project. Go to the root of one of your drives, typically this is the C drive or the D drive. I assume that you are planning to attend a series of Python classes, therefore, we create a folder called My Python Class. I recommend not using spaces or special characters in the folder name, keep it simple. Within the newly created folder, we create a subfolder. This subfolder represents a lesson from your hypothetical Python class. Please name the folder Lesson 1. Repeat the process for another subfolder named Lesson 2. Open again the Windows command prompt by typing CMD in the search field. Then click on Command Prompt. The next steps will show you the typical workflow when working with Jupyter Notebook. This should get you started with most Python education programs such as Udacity, Udemy, or Coursera. Now type the drive letter where you created the folders in the previous step followed by a semicolon, and then press Enter. This step is not necessary if you created the folders on the C drive. Use the dir command to display a list of files and subfolders. You should recognize the folder with the name, My Python Class, that we created earlier. With the cd command followed by a space and the folder name, My Python Class, we can change into the folder My Python Class. Using the dir command again shows us the two folders Lesson 1 and Lesson 2 that we have created previously. The next step is important. Type Jupyter Notebook and press Enter. This will open a Jupyter tab in your web browser. Jupyter will show the files at the location when you started Jupyter. In our case, this is inside the folder My Python Class, showing the two folders Lesson 1 and Lesson 2. Now go into the folder, Lesson 1, and create a new Python 3 notebook by clicking on the New button in the top right corner. At the moment, the notebook is named, Untitled, as you can see in the top left corner. Please rename it to, My First Notebook, as shown in the video. In a Jupyter notebook, each cell can have basically one of two types, markdown, and code. Markdown is used for documentation purposes. Let's define the first cell as a markdown cell. Then type hashtag, followed by a text of your choice as seen in the video. Below the hashtag line you can add additional text which will be rendered as normal text. The cell is executed with Shift plus Enter. As you can see, the hashtag line is rendered as a heading. Now let's type 1 plus 1 in the code cell below. Execute the cell using Shift plus Enter again. Save the notebook by clicking the disk icon in the top left corner. Then click on the Jupyter logo to return to the Jupyter dashboard. Now create a new Python 3 notebook within the folder, Lesson 2, as shown in the video. Rename the notebook as shown in the video. Play with the code cell as shown in the video. Save the notebook by clicking the disk icon in the top left corner. Then click on the Jupyter logo to return to the Jupyter dashboard. Now you can go back to the folder Lesson 1 and open the notebook that you have created previously. Go to the menu item, Kernel, and choose Restart and Run All. This will execute all cells in the notebook. Save the notebook and close all open browser tabs. Congratulations, you are now familiar with the basic workflow of using Python in combination with Jupyter Notebook. This tutorial is now finished. You can stay if you want, and I will show you some details about the creation of this tutorial. The last and optional part of this video is the making of. It took quite some time to make this short tutorial video. In total, I spent about 20 hours of my free time creating this tutorial. The 20 hours were spread over 4 to 5 weekends. I had different software installed on my laptop that helped me creating this tutorial. If possible, I used free software, but I purchased the software Camtasia, because I did not find a good free alternative. Finally, I used two online services. One for generating the voice that you hear right now and another one for the images that I used to make the slides nicer. This is the end of the tutorial. Have fun, be awesome. And don't let Python ruin your day.